Nine new shark cards surfacing big jaws. Okay, this is a 1800 attack, 300 defense, level 4 fish effect monster. You can only use each effect, first and second, of this card once per turn. During the main phase, if you activated a spell this turn, you can special summon this card from your hand. Also, you cannot special summon monsters from the extra deck for the rest of the tournament except XCs. Then it says this card is normal or special. You can add a shark fish monster from deck to hand. Okay, so free special and a search. Very nice. If this card is used for XCs, summon of a water monster, you can also treat it as level 3 or 5. So giving you some options. This card's good. I don't know exactly what this deck plays or even does really, but this card seems pretty solid. Next up we have Drake Shark. Hello. This card is a 1400 attack, 1050 defense, level 4 water fish effect monster. You can only use each of the first and second effect of this card's name once per turn. This card's added to your hand, except by drawing it you can special summon it. They gave sharks a poplar. Okay, dope. You just special summon this. If you activated a spell, search this, special summon this. And then it says if you use this card as material for the XC summon of a water monster that uses three or more materials, you can treat this card as two materials. Interesting. What can you do with that? That's crazy. What water XCs needs three or more materials? That's like kind of busted. I need you guys to let me know. I don't really know. And the last effect, a shark drake XCs monster with this card as material gains the following effect. Once per turn, you can detach two materials from this card, then target spell trap on the field, attach it to this card as material. Okay, so that's pretty good. Quite a few need three or more, to be honest. The new XCs. Okay, maybe we'll get to that. This card also seems really good. I don't know how you could utilize the three material thing. Like I said, I don't know too much about the water stuff, but this card also seems good. This is just poplar. And also attaching a spell trap on the field as material is obviously better than destruction. So armor shark, level 3, 500 attack, 2000 defense, fish effect monster. This card is always treated as an armored XC's card. You can only use each of the first and second effect of this card's name once per turn. You can send a water XC's monster from your extra deck to the graveyard. Okay, toad, add back, nice. Then target a fish monster in your graveyard whose level equal to the sent monster's rank, special it. And then during your opponent's turn, if this card is in the graveyard, quick effect, you can target one water XC's monster you control. Equip this card to it as gives a 500, equip spell gives a 500 attack. This one doesn't seem that good. Moving on, we have number C32 Shark Drake Revise. Okay, 3100 attack, 2600 defense, rank 5 XCs, sea serpent, 4 level 5 monsters. You can also special summon this card by discarding one spell and using one rank 4 shark drake XCs monster you control as material. Treat it as an XCs summon, transfer the materials to this card. Okay, so this is a way to cheat it out. And then it says once per turn, quick effect, you can detach one material from this card, then target one effect monster your opponent negates effects, and if you do, its attack and defense become 0 and can make 2 attacks during each battle phase. So this card, you can just, if you discard a spell, you can slap over what you make from this, and it's just a quick effect negate. Like, this one's not bad. This is kind of just shisha out here. This card's good for sharks. I don't know, like, what the water shark fish deck does. It seems solid. So let's go on to the next one. Leviathan Dragon. Okay, rank 3. Sea Serpent XCs, 2 level 3 monsters. You can only use each effect, 1 and 2 of this card's name once per turn. If this card is special summon, you can add a virtue stream from your deck to your hand. Is that a new card or is that card already out? It's a new card. Okay, so maybe we'll get to that. Detach one material from your field. Okay, so it can detach from anything. Add a fish, sea serpent, or aqua monster from your graveyard to your hand except itself. And then the second effect, target 2 XCs monsters on the field, attach one to the other as material. This part seems like okay, like add one back from the graveyard is fine. I don't know how good virtue stream is. Depending on how good that card is, then this card would be pretty good, but I'm not sure. Going on to a normal spell, we got aqua jet surface. A normal spell, you can only use each effect, 1 and 2 of this card once per turn. All these cards have 2 or 3 effects. Special summon one fish, sea serpent, or aqua monster from your hand or graveyard. Also, while you control that face-up monster, you cannot special summon mods from the extra deck except XC's monsters. And then, if your opponent controls the attack with this monster, you can banish cards from your graveyard and target a fish, sea serpent, or aqua monster you control. It gains 1000 attack. Okay, virtue stream. This is, it's a normal trap. So this is what this new levy thing searches. Normal trap, you can only use each of the 1 and 2 effects of this card
once per turn. First effect, target a fish, sea serpent, or aqua monster you control, and two cards your opponent controls destroy them. So it's blackout. Second effect, you can banish a card from your graveyard, then target a face-up monster on the field. Apply the effect depending on its attribute. Water this time. The first time this river is destroyed, it's not non-water. Target becomes water. Okay. I like this card. There's like probably some cute stuff you could do with this right here. It's not crazy or anything like that. I don't know. The first thing I think of is like Lubellion tributing a dark dragon to summon itself from the graveyard. You get like pop two if they try to extend with a bestial. I mean, this is just the first thing I'm thinking of. If they summon a bestial or a level 6 or higher dark dragon, you can like banish it, change it to water. Now you can't summon Lubellion. There's like cute stuff you can do like that with it. On top of that is just blackout. So I think this card is nice, bro. I think this card is nice. It's searchable. Okay, last card here. We have Xyz Poseidon Splash. Normal trap card. You can only use one of the first or second effect of this card once per turn. If you control an Xyz monster with an Xyz monster card as material, declare one attribute on the field. Destroy all monsters with that attribute except the monster that are equipped with an equip spell. And the second effect, you banish a card from your graveyard, then detach one material from your field. Special summon a fish, sea serpent, or aqua monster from your graveyard to either side of the field. Trying to be good against fire. I think it's an anime card. Oh, is this from the anime set that's coming out? Is that what it is? This card, I don't know about. This one's definitely not as good as the blackout trap card, I think. Because you have to, if you control an Xyz monster with an Xyz monster as material, which I guess is not hard to do, but I don't know if this one's searchable. Even if it is searchable, I just think it's worse than like this one. And I don't think you're going to play more than one of this trap or more than one like trap in your deck. Okay, man. Like these cards are pretty good. Obviously, I can't see the future and know if that they're going to be meta or not. But they seem like they have a strategy, you know? Like this card's pretty good. Special summon. If you activate a spell card, search this. Special summon this. You can special summon the quick effect guy, or you could make this search. Like, I'm pretty sure they have a lot of extenders. The new Leviathan Xyz monster is a retrain of the original Leviathan. I knew this guy looked familiar, but dope, bro. Dope. Appreciate the link. And now I think we hop on to some Master Duel.